What's up, YouTube? This is Justin. I'm feeling kind of spunky today. You know what? It's the third day of Lent, and I got to tell you how much Jesus owes me. Yeah, Jesus owes me so much, it's ridiculous. You know why? Because I was baptized as a little baby. So Jesus owes me. I got some oil on my head. So Jesus owes me. So Jesus owes me. I take the Eucharist every Sunday. So Jesus owes me. So Jesus owes me. I confess my sins every single week. So Jesus owes me. I get spiritual advice from a pastor. So Jesus owes me. He owes me so much. I'm gonna get to heaven and be like, I so deserve to be here, because Jesus owes me. Jesus owes me. I've done so much to earn the cross that he died on. So Jesus owes me. So Jesus owes me. It's like Tom Hanks said at the end of Saving Private Ryan, Jesus owes me because I've earned this. Now, you know what? Obviously, I hope you know that I'm being very tongue-in-cheek in that, because there's no way that any person could ever earn the sacrifice of Jesus Christ on the cross. There's no way. That is huge. What did he do? He redeemed the entire world. He died for you. He died for me. He died for the church. He died for the whole world. And to think that by getting baptized, you are earning your salvation. To think that you are earning the salvation by walking up to the chalice and opening your mouth and believing that Jesus is actually present in the sacraments. To believe that you have earned your salvation because you don't eat meat on Wednesdays and Fridays. If that's your reason for not eating meat on Wednesdays and Fridays and periodically throughout Lent, that's a terrible, terrible understanding of why we live the life that we live. You know, if your understanding of anything that we do as an Orthodox Christian is because I want to go to heaven, it kind of slaps the face of Jesus Christ and what he has done for us. Look, he came and he said, you know what? My yoke is light. My burden is easy. And it drives me nuts when people accuse Orthodox Christians in believing in a salvation by works, like we're Pelagian or something. Because we're not. It's very simple. Why do we not eat meat on Wednesdays and Fridays? If you think the answer is, well, because, you know, I want to go to heaven, that's nonsense. Right, we don't eat meat on Wednesday because we remember that Jesus was betrayed on Wednesday. And that's one way that we can remember that. Or, you know, why is it that we don't eat meat on Fridays? Well, because Jesus was crucified and killed on a Friday. So it's why we don't eat meat on Fridays. Not to earn our salvation. And why do we go to church on Sunday? To earn our salvation? No, we go to church on Sunday because Jesus was resurrected from the dead. And we celebrate that. Why do we take the Eucharist? We take the Eucharist because Jesus is there and present to forgive our sins. Why do we go to our confession? We confess our sins because we are, one, sinners, right? And that's, I guess that ultimately proves why it's not a salvation by self-righteousness. How can I possibly be gloating over the fact that I go to confession? That's impossible. The fact that I went to confession just means that I sin, and that I need help, that I don't know what to do, that I need some practical advice from my pastor to deal with the struggles that I deal with on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis. I need examples. I need help. I need someone to help me understand what motivates my actions and what motivates my thoughts and get some advice on how to do that. Why do I say the Jesus prayer, Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner? Because he's the only one who can help me. Jesus is the only one who can help me. You gotta understand, what makes salvation by works a thing is this idea that you are worthy to receive salvation because of the work of man. So, for example, if I, you know, I say I'm so holy that I don't eat pork, and because, you know, my forefathers is Abraham, and because I, you know, I'm connected to Abraham. Or if I believe that I am holy because I did something, you know? I'm holy because of me, because of what I've accomplished, because of how much I fast, I'm holy, because of how much I give, I'm holy, because I give sacrifices, or because I give money, I'm holy, or because I, anything that is done with the understanding that I'm doing it because I'm holy, and me doing it makes me holy, that's what salvation by works is. That's what it means. But if you're doing something in acknowledgement of your own sinfulness for the glory of God, that's not salvation by works. That's the exact opposite. It's all about the motivations of the individual for why they do the things that they do. If I do things in my own name because I want people to know what I did, I fast with a face that's just downtrodden, and I go around work and I go, oh, I'm fasting. I feel so weak. Oh, my boss, I'm gonna have a hard time fulfilling all of my workly obligations because I'm fasting. It's nonsense. What you're doing is you're just drawing attention to yourself. It's sort of like when the Pharisees, when they would go and give to the temple treasury, they literally toot a horn. Look at me, I'm putting money in a box for the temple. No, man, let your giving be secret so that your Father can reward you openly. But if you're doing things for your own glorification, then you've gotten your reward. That's what Jesus says. So no, the sacraments are not an acknowledgement of how righteous you are. The sacraments are your acknowledgement of how sinful you are and how much you need Jesus. And that's the core. That's the difference between salvation by works and works righteousness and the sacramental life, which is nothing to do with how great you are, but how great Christ is and how fallen you are, how fallen I am. So living the Orthodox life is, in a lot of ways, the answer to Calvinism. You know, Calvinism says, hey, you know what, you're totally depraved. Orthodoxy says, yeah, so we need Jesus. We need Jesus in every aspect of my life. I need to say the Jesus prayer. Hey, Lord Jesus Christ, have mercy on me, a sinner. Father, have mercy on me. You know, I need to pray the Our Father. I need prayer from my priest, and I need prayer from my wife and my kids. I need the prayer of all the saints to help me on a daily basis because I'm fallen. I'm broken. I can't do it by myself. I can't. And the sacraments are a grace of God. It's a work of God. I'm not putting Jesus in the wine. Jesus puts himself in the wine. I'm not putting the Holy Spirit in the waters of baptism. The Holy Spirit puts himself in the waters of baptism. I'm not putting the Holy Spirit in the oil to you know, when I'm sick? No, the Holy Spirit is present there. That's all the work of God, and I'm participating in the work of God. This is, it's like suggesting that, you know, when the priests would take up the Ark of the Covenant and put it on their shoulders, as if doing that made victory happen, you know, in the battles. Because they brought the Ark of the Covenant. No. Them picking up the Ark of the Covenant didn't bring them victory. What brought them victory was the Spirit of God that was in the Ark of the Covenant. You know? So people don't understand, you know, there's, you know, every time we partake of a sacrament, we're acknowledging our sinfulness. You know? When I'm baptized, I'm baptized for the remission of sins. When I receive the Holy Spirit, I'm putting off my dead self and I'm putting on Christ. I'm crucifying myself to this world, and I'm participating in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. And when I take the Eucharist, it's for the forgiveness of sins and life everlasting. Because, you know, even after baptism, I still sin. And when I confess my sins, it's because I sinned. When I'm sick and I confess my sins and receive healing, it's because I understand that there's some sort of correlation. The reason why sickness is in the world is because of our sins. If we all lived perfect lives, nobody would be sick. But that's not the case. And no, I'm not suggesting that people who have cancer deserve to have cancer. That's not at all what I'm saying. I'm just saying that the burden of sin on this world leads to all sorts of problems. It leads to problems in medicine. It leads to problems in agriculture. It leads to problems in politics. No matter what, sin corrupts and destroys everything. And we are under that burden all the time, which is why we need Jesus. Need him. We don't have anyone else. He's the way. He's the truth. He's the light. Anyways, guys, if this helps you out, you know, go ahead and hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. If you have any questions, please leave a comment in the comment section. I'll definitely respond with you. I hope you guys have a blessed Lent, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.